legend lives on from the Chippewa on down at the big lake they call Gitchagumi. The lake, it is said, never gives up her dead when the skies of November turn gloomy. With a load of iron ore, 26,000 tons more than the Edmund Fitzgerald weighed empty. That good ship and true was a bone to be chewed when the gales of November came early. The ship was the pride of the American side, coming back from some mill in Wisconsin. As the big freighters go, it was bigger than most, with a crew and good captain well seasoned. Concluding some terms with a couple of steel firms when they left fully loaded for Cleveland. Then later that night when the ship's bell rang, could it be the north wind they'd been feeling? The wind and the wires made a tattletale sound, and the wave broke over the railing. And every man knew, as the captain did too, 'twas the witch of November come stealing. The dawn came late and the breakfast had to wait when the gales of November came slashing. When afternoon came, it was freezing rain in the face of a hurricane west wind. When supper time came, the old cook came on deck saying, "Fellas, it's too rough to feed you." At 7 p.m. a main hatchway gave in. He said, "Fellas, it's been good to know you." The captain wired in, he had water coming in, and the good ship and crew was in peril. And later that night when his lights went out of sight, came the wreck of the Edmund Fitzgerald. Does anyone know where the love of God goes when the waves turn the minutes to hours? The searchers all say they'd have made Whitefish Bay if they'd put 15 more miles behind her. They might have split up or they might have capsized. They may have broke deep and took water. All that remains is the faces and the names of the wives and the sons and the daughters. Lake Huron rolls, Superior sings in the rooms of her ice water mansion. Old Michigan steams like a young man's dreams. The islands and bays are for sportsmen. And farther below, Lake Ontario takes in what Lake Erie can send her. The iron boats go, as the mariners all know, with the gales of November remembered. In a musty old hall in Detroit, they prayed in the Maritime Sailors' Cathedral. The church bell chimed till it rang 29 times for each man on the Edmund Fitzgerald. And the legend lives on from the Chippewa on down of the big lake they call Gitche-Gumee. Superior, they said, never gives up her dead when the gales of November come early.
the sea where the sea world is, and she waits for the man to come. She lives in town with her high-heeled friends, and she knows it's a long way down, but she doesn't have to get up in the morning with her hair so soft and low.
If you'd like to spend an afternoon approaching lavender, you'll feel just fine, but one thing's sure, you'll never be the same. If you'd like to try your hand at understanding lavender, then you must be very sure that life is not a game. You might even learn a thing or two approaching lavender. You'll soon be on a one-night tour forgetting your own name. You won't need a reason just to be alone with lavender, for the light so warm and pure will draw you like a flame. Colors that surround you, there will be the shade of lavender, shadows dancing everywhere like flowers in the rain. will find your tongues on fire while lying next to lavender, with the words you never spoke before and could not speak again. Oh, sweet lavender, I understand you perfectly. There is no way that I can see you living by yourself. Oh, sweet lavender, I must be with you constantly. Your presence means so much to me, much more than life itself. Sweet lavender, as fragrant as the name you bear, please cast away the clothes you wear and give your love to me. Oh, sweet lavender, your smile is like the golden summer, and I'd love to see you laugh and run as naked as the sea. Like to spend an afternoon approaching lavender, don't try and get the best of her, she will not share the blame. If you'd like to try your hand at understanding lavender, then you must be very sure that life is not a game. There is no shame.